and I appreciate you opening this in prayer. I appreciate all of you coming out tonight. I hope this is something that becomes an annual tradition, that we can go from to the different churches in our ministerial alliance and do this every year. It's a dream of mine, so we'll see how that comes out. This came to my mind probably about 2 weeks before Thanksgiving, and the community choir was doing so well with their community, with their special music that we were working on. I said, you know, you people need to be singing Christmas. I mean, two nights a year is just not enough. I said, would you want to learn the music that our choir at the Baptist Church is doing? Would you want to learn that Christmas music? And they said, sure. And within a month, they have jumped in and learned it. And so we put it all together. And I am just overjoyed to see so many of you here tonight. So I pray that you will worship with us tonight. The words will be on the screen, because I like to do that, because sometimes the songs are going to be familiar and you'll know them. Half of them you probably won't, and I hope you enjoy them anyway. And the words will be on the screen so that you can really take in the message and really take it to heart. That's why we're here, to do that and to glorify the Lord.
Amen. outside of Bethlehem echoed with the sounds of angels singing. The prophet Isaiah had foretold the miracle that would happen. He said, "Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel." Every song we sing about his birth celebrates the name that means God with us.
After a silence that lasted 400 years, it was a baby's cry from a manger that announced that heaven had sent help to all who would receive it. The long-promised Holy One of God had come to be our hope and our Messiah. And that is good news.
You all find him wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. The world desperately needing saving then, and it still does. The word Savior has moved hearts down through the centuries.
The message of the angel to the shepherds hasn't changed. A Savior has been born for us. He came to rescue us from the fall. This is Jesus, Prince of Peace, King of Glory, Lord of all.
angels who sang creation's story now proclaim the Messiah's birth. Can you imagine that holy night? What it must have been like for the shepherds to hear the angels' chorus announce the birth of a newborn king?
The response is no surprise. They ran to see the promise of God fulfilled.
Come.
Isaiah wrote, "The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shone."
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life." And from the Gospel of John, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it."
Stars.
No one else in all of creation is worthy. He alone could take our sins upon himself and pay the debt for us. But there is more. The birth, life, and death of Jesus, even his resurrection, are leading to something so good and glorious, and yet so astonishingly simple, a new earth, a new creation. He is remaking what the fall destroyed. He is ransoming a people for himself from every tribe, nation, tongue, making a kingdom, and we shall reign on the earth. That, my friends, is a staggering promise. It's good, good news.
Yes, the incarnation and crucifixion are important, but we mustn't stop short of the climax of the story. You and I won't be floating on cartoon clouds. We'll be tending a new garden as ransomed, redeemed, resurrected, fully human beings, living to glorify Jesus himself, who alone deserves all blessing and honor and glory. So we thank God today for the indescribable gift of his Son.
Is he worthy?
message that a significant event has occurred.
And the most significant part of Christmas is the gift of God's Son. Let the bells ring.